Assalamu alaikum. Today we are in camp called Gawi in the center of N'Djamena, the capital of Chad. Here, which having about more than 5,000 refugees coming from African, from Central African Republic after the ethnic cleansing which has been happening over the last 5 years. This camp opened in 2014 and it has about more than 5,000 people. Women are about 2,200, children are about 1,800, and men about 936. As you can see the children here now, it is, can you see the children? The children here are going in one school, primary school, which having 600 children only, but there's no secondary school for the rest of the children in this camp. The number of latrines here is 30. It used to be 80, but actually 50 are not working and only 30 is available. And the number of deep wells or wells that you can see here, it is about 12 is working out of 18. There's no clinic, there's no doctor in this camp, and people having a lot of problems here because of lack of funding. There's no proper organization to look after them. What they want from us here is to help them because they need a lot of help and they need a lot of support. You can see the condition of the tents. Can you see the condition of the tents? Which have not been changed since 2015, and it's a very, very difficult condition for the people here to live. And actually, in this very hot country, and sometimes when it rains heavy. And the diseases, the common disease here is malaria, which is need a lot of treatment. Some second disease is diarrhea, and which affecting a lot of children and women as well. And those people also need from us one thing. They don't want to keep stretching their hands for help and for aid, but they want us to educate them, to train them, to enable them to earn their living in this area till they go back to their own country. Occasionally, some of the Arab countries or some other organizations from Arab countries and Muslim organizations come during Ramadan and during Qurbani to give them some food. But this is not enough because we need sustainable supply of food, material, and medical aid to the people in this camp. And all this information we got from brother Musa Bashir is in charge of the camp. So what we need here, as you can see, some of the children, there's no hope for those children to live. There's no hope for those people to go back, but we would like to help you to help them as much as we can and to stop the ethnic cleansing inside Central African Republic, actually, because it is affecting the lives of thousands and thousands, tens of thousands and hundreds of thousands of people who are here running to save their own life. The government is unable here because the government is not a very rich government, as you understand. And unfortunately, in Chad, there are more than 600,000 refugees from different countries, from Central African Republic, from Congo, Democratic Republic of Congo, from Nigeria, from Niger, from Chad. And here we can see that actually the government of Chad is doing far more better job than the governments in Europe and America by hosting more than 600,000 people. And this is our appeal to the United Nations and to the European Union and to other big organizations to compare the suffering of the government of Chad hosting those 600,000 people and the lack of support actually from different governments, rich governments, either from the north or from the south or from the east or from the west. Our appeal to you, young men and young women, is come and help those children, come and help those people living in this difficult situation, in this camp, or not only in this camp, in many camps here in Chad, not only one camp, but many camps, and sometimes those people have to do some unlawful work to try to earn their living, to sustain their family, especially the young girls and the young woman who might be abused to earn some living from people outside the camp. So please, my appeal to you here is Chad is having a big burden of hosting more than 600,000 people and as refugees, and we need more organizations to come here, we need more people to come here, we need more volunteers to come here to advocate the case of Chad actually and to help the people of Chad and help those children. You can see them everywhere, more than 1,800 children.